Welcome to another 24/7 Office video. Today we'll be covering the accounting module. Like all our modules, we have a left side panel to navigate. A typical workflow starts under retrieval. All receipts and invoices end up in this section for processing, and as you will see with this workflow, you will keep documentation and audit trail of all your invoices. Furthermore, in the retrieval center, you assign and select pages for processing. You can do that by either dragging them into the processing area or use the arrow keys to select the pages that you want to process. You can unselect them by crossing them out. The next step is to type in the vendor's name and assign the appropriate debit and credit account. Our system uses OCR to read off the information from the invoice, such as invoice number, invoice date, due dates, and amount. You can also add a description that will follow the journal entry. Moreover, you can add dimensional accounting. We have projects and departments, but you can also add customized dimensions. The comments section here is for the approvers. Then you can add it to the general ledger by posting it directly from the retrieval center, or you could add an approval process to it. Here you select the approvers, or if you have set up approval rules, simply hit the checkbox. You also have the option to display the invoice on an external display. So once you hit ready, the invoice will be sent to the next step, which is approval. As an approver, I go to the approval section, and I select the invoice. Here you can review the invoice, you can also make necessary changes as well as see the posting information, the history or the audit trail. The approver will either approve the invoice, decline it or forward it to another approver. The next section is posting. It's in this section that we finalize the accounts payable workflow. Here we set up two journal entries by selecting the approved invoices or accounts payables. Proceed to the stamp number section, use the arrow keys, and select the invoice. We choose the entry type, and you usually have the invoices displayed on the right side. However, you can also arrange to have it displayed on the top. Most of the time you would have it shown on an external monitor. As you select an invoice, the system will populate the information entered in the retrieval section. You will only have to make changes if you're applying accruals or deferrals. The accounting module in 24/7 Office is feature-rich and powerful, and it's designed to handle both basic and advanced accounting tasks. This module has access to a variety of hotkeys to speed up the workflow, and you can add and remove columns to your business needs. So for instance, if you don't need a specific section, like period, you can go to the segment here and remove it. Look through the information and make sure everything is as it should be. Hit save, and it's ready for posting. As you complete the journal entry, the system will open up a window with the transaction list. This shows you the journal entry and can also be accessed through various reports. Under report, you can access the Echoscope. This is an extended report feature of our accounting module. Here you can choose between a selection of standard templates. You can also set up a customized report and filter by different parameters. Moreover, you can aggregate the data the way you need by different filters. To give you a quick show, one of your options is date. Secondly, you have dimension. And last, you have information. If we go back to the accounting module's dashboard, we can find the transaction search. This lets you look up journal entries. On the right-hand side, you have a set of filters and parameters. You can choose from what date it should collect and show invoices, and you can sort the invoices however you want. If you look up the vendor Google, all the transactions for this vendor are shown. You can even drill down to the voucher or invoice if you double-click the invoice. Lastly, we have the settings. Here you can set up when you want to receive notifications. You can add accounts to the chart of accounts, tax codes, departments, currencies. You can also apply specific rules. Everything from account limits to fixed approvers. You can create your own rules once you get familiar with the system. Thank you so much for watching, and if you're interested in trying out 24/7 Office, go to 24/7office.com and sign up for a free trial. Have a nice day.